for that prayer this morning. I tell you, it's nothing like prayer. It was needed. It was much needed. It was just awesome. I thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Now, as my book is 1 Peter and 2 Peter. We're going to get into it. First, a word of prayer, and then we'll start. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I thank you, Lord, for your presence. I thank you for your glory. I thank you for raining down supremely in me, Father God. Father God, I empty out that you may pour in, Father God. Father God, let this word be fruitful and multiply. Let it fall on good ground and soil, Father God. Lord, I thank you for it. Let it rain. Lord, I thank you for your people, Lord. Let them hear the word and be doers of the word, Father God. Father God, in your mighty name, we praise you and we worship you in truth. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Amen. I'm excited. You know, anytime, you know, you get before God's people, and he gives you the word, you're anxious and you're excited, and you know, you just want to make God proud, which I know he's proud of his people, because I'm proud of him. So I'm in 2 Peter on the first chapter, and let's read. Simon Peter, a servant and an apostle of Jesus Christ, to them that have attained like precious faith with us through the righteousness of God and our Savior Jesus Christ. Grace and peace be multiplied unto you, those the knowledge of God and Jesus our Lord, according as his divine power has given unto us all things that pertain unto life and godliness, Lord, and knowledge of him that has called us to glory and virtue, whereby are given unto us exceedingly great and precious promise, that by these ye might be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corrupting that is in the world, through lust. And beside this, giving all diligence, adding to all faith virtue, and to virtue knowledge, and to knowledge temperance, and to temperance patience, and to patience godliness, and to godliness brotherliness, kindness, and to brotherliness kindliness charity. For if these things be in you and abound, that they may you make you that ye shall neither be barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. But he that lacketh these things is blind and cannot see afar off, and has forgotten that he was purged from his old sins. Wherefore, the brethren, giving diligently to make his calling and his election sure. For if ye do these things, ye shall never fall, for so an entrance shall be ministered unto you and abundantly into the everlasting kingdom of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Wherefore, I will not be negligent to put you away in remembrance of these things, so ye know them and be established in the presence truth. Yea, I think it's meek, as long as I am in this tabernacle, to stir you up by putting you in the remembrance, knowing that surely I must be put off this my tabernacle, even as our Lord Jesus Christ has showed me. Moreover, I will endeavor that ye may be able after my decease to have these things always in remembrance, for we have not followed cunningly devised fables when we make known unto you the power and coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, but were witness of his majesty, for he received from God the Father honor and glory when there came such a voice to him from the excellent glory, "This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased." And this voice which comes from heaven we heard when we were with him in holy mountains. We have also a more sure word of prophecy, whereunto ye do well that ye take heed, as unto a light that shineth in the darkness, placed until the day of dawn. The day starts arise in the heart, knowing this first, that no prophecy of the scripture is of any private interpretation. For prophecy came not in old time by the will of man, but holy men of God speaking as they were moved by the Holy Ghost. Amen. Oh, man. God is telling us that he's with us. And as you know, that the message that came last Sunday, that God is in the presence and he's given us no fear. And anything that God wants for us, he will give us. And so I thank God for the word. And I thank God for Wednesday. You know, it's an encouragement to understand. This is an encouraging word. And the title, forgive me, of my lesson is "He Knows Our Name." Amen. Man, it's a good thing that God knows our name. Praise the Lord. He knows all about us. He knows everything that we sometimes think he don't know. I mean, he knew all about Peter before Peter was, you know, equipped to do the job. He knew the job that Peter was going to do. He knew the way that Peter was going to go. So much like today, he knows the job we need to do, the way we're going to go. And sometimes I think we forget that God is all present, and he's everywhere, and he's all time, and he exists, you know, every place that there is that we are. God is good. And so he's been telling us lately that I know that you've been struggling, and I know that you've been going through, and I know that, you know, there's some things, you know, that you may even think that, where are you, Jesus? Where are you, God? But God knew. He knew this day would come. He knew your name before you were born. He knew you in the womb. You know, he knew your work. He knew what you were supposed to do. He knew what you wouldn't do. Oh, praise the Lord. I thank God this morning, because I thank God for knowing about me. You know, you this is like personal. You have to take it personal. You know, Peter, personal. You have to take it personal that God knows your name. He knows what you can do. He knows everything that about you. Oh, praise the Lord. I thank God. I thank God. You know, the message was delivered that God has given it unto me. And I'm one that says, you know, he knows your name, Elder Harris. He knows your name, Elder Stubblefield. He knows your name, Pastor. He knows your name, men and women of greater life. He knows your name. Oh, yes, God. Yes, God. When you know that God knows who you are,
That means you lose yourself, and you get gain the trust, and you fall into the presence of Jesus, and you get to a point where you just say, I don't care what is ahead of me, but I thank God that He's with me. You see, He knew this day would come. He knew that you were going to either fall back or you was going to step up. Amen. He knows. He knows us better than anyone, you know, and God wants you to know, I know you. So guess what? All you have to do is keep on continuing to praise me. All you have to do is continue to worship me. All you have to do is just love on me the way I love on you. Is it something that when you forget about your problems and think on the presence of God, that everything else does not matter but the love of God and then the work of God? And I have so much work to do. You have so much work to do. Realize that you are a child of God. You are. Oh, praise the Lord. Sister Betty, you are a child of God. And He knows your name. Amen. Turn with me to Psalms 91. Amen. I'm going to read into your hearing Psalm 91, verse 3 through 4. And this is what God has given it to me. This is like in the midnight hour. Oh, praise the Lord. Amen. Psalm 91, verse 3 to 4 says this: surely He shall deliver thee from the snares of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with His feathers, and under His wings shall thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and buckler. In that presence, in that mindset, the midnight hour has arrived. And God is present. And He says, He should deliver thee from the noise and pestilence and stuff, meaning that outside negativity that you are experiencing will cease. He has covered you with His feathers, and under His wings shall thou trust. Do you trust God today? Do you really trust God today? He already knows everything about you. He already knows if you're going to have an up day or a down day. You have to ask yourself, where is my trust? Where is my belief in my God? You got to take this personal. Where is it? Do I have it? Oh, praise the Lord. And it says His truth, not mine, shall be my shield and my buckler, meaning that He shall be He's protecting me. He's got me covered. He's got you covered. He's got you. He shields you from danger or harm many times. And so you may be experiencing something and ask yourself, where is God? But as the many times before that He has shown Himself to you, He shall deliver you again out of this. He's delivered you many times. So what makes you think He will not deliver you again out of this? Do you know His name? Because He surely knows your name. Oh, praise the Lord. Oh, praise the Lord. In the midnight hour, God knows everything about you, greater light. He knows what you're going to do. He know what you're going to say. He know when and how it's going to be done. Amen. Turn with me to Matthew's. Amen. Oh, praise the Lord. I won't be before you long. But God has given me this, and I shall deliver it in the name of Jesus, because he's worthy of all praises. Matthew chapter 11. Chapter 11 and verse 28 to 30. And it says this, his word. It says, come unto me, all ye laborers and of hearty lad, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and ye shall find rest unto my soul. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. You know, we start to give up, people. We start to forget that God is right there, and he's in our presence. And at that very moment, this verse says, and I say Jesus, because that's what he gave me, Jesus tells you in verse 30, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Where is it that we forget that God's word is true, that he is real? He is real to what? Me. He is real to you. There is no giving up in Jesus. It's his name. It says, no man cometh to the Father but by the Son. That means you have to know Jesus in order to come to the Father, which is God. God is trying to equip his people today, this morning, to let them know that I know you. And I have a question. Do you know him? He knows you, Greater Light. He knows you. He knows everything about you. He knew everything about Peter. God wants you to know that he will never leave you, and you have a pastor say that, or forsake you. God is always in your midst, and he's always in your presence, and he's always, always, always. You mean always means always, what exactly what the word means. He never sleeps, he never slumbers. He's always there. He's always on the job. That means that you should be on the job. Amen. You should tell yourself, Lord, what is it that you want me to do? Where is it that you want me to go? You see, this is not about me, but some about me. This is all about your work, your goodness, and your endurance in this house. Oh, praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. God is good. He's so good that every time that you speak, you should be thanking God and giving him glory. Yeah, some things don't look pretty, and some things extreme and all this bizarre stuff, as like you can see right now at this time and this age is going on in this world. But God is with you. God says, here I am. Greater Light, here I am. He's speaking to us. He's been speaking to us for a while now. For a while. And it's up to us to get up. It's up to us to announce that we know, okay, God, thank you. Lord, I thank you, Lord, for all that I go through. Lord, I thank you for every single thing about my life, because I had no life before you gave life. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, have your way. Turn with me to Joel. In Joel, I will be reading. Out of the second chapter and verse 28 and 32. And how he gave it to me is, this is how we should be wanting God. Fall on me, Lord. Let your presence fall on me. Amen. And it shall come to pass, let's read, afterwards that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams, and your young men shall see visions. And it also upon the servants and upon the handmaids. And in these days will I pour out my spirit, and I will show wonders in the heavens and in the earth, blood and fire and pillars of smoke. The sun shall turn into darkness and the moon into blood before the great and terrible days of the Lord coming. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be delivered. For in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem shall he be deliberate, as the Lord has said, and in the remnants whom the Lord shall call. Lord, this is just me. I take it personal. Lord, let your presence and let your rain fall on me. Oh, I thank God for his presence and his rain falling in my house. You see, you should be grateful and thankful and tell God, thank you for your presence falling on my house, falling on me. Lord, fall on me. You see, when it gets hard, I need you to fall on me. When I get to the point where I can't bear it, fall on me. Lord, fall on my children. Lord, fall on my family. Lord, fall on my friends. Lord, fall on everything that concerns me, Father God. In the name of Jesus. You see, when you start to get to a place where you are excited and ecstatic about God, hallelujah, because his presence is almighty, and the falling of him, his presence on you, hallelujah, makes the devil tremble and moves things and shifted things that needed to be moved and shift. That means God is falling on you. And in that falling on you, God is saying, you have work to do. So greater life, we have work to do. We've been getting this meat and we've been eating. I know I've been eating. I'm thinking that you've been eating too. And in that place where you've been eating, you be getting up and you begin to tell God thank you in the midst of a storm, because that storm won't last forever, but God does. And I come to tell you this morning, he knows your name. He knows your name sure enough, because he's God Almighty. Jesus, hallelujah. I thank God for his might and his will and his power that resides in me. Oh, come on, somebody. You need to get up and tell God thank you. This is your time. This is your moment to go ahead and announce God, no matter what. I am a servant and a child of you. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, yeah, by that deep seat, by. Amen. Turn with me to Hebrews. Oh, glory, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. God is having his way in this house. And I'll be reading from Hebrews chapter 13, verse 5 through 8. Let's read. And it says,
Let your conversation be without covetousness, and be content with such things as ye have, for he has said, I will never leave you nor forsake thee, so that we may boldly say, the Lord is my helper, and I will not fear what man shall do unto me. Remember them which has ruled over you, who has spoken unto you the word of God, whose faith follows, considering the end of their conversation. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday and today and forever. Is it such that God loves us so much that he has told us he'd never leave us or forsake us? And then in, see, verse 6, the Lord is our help, and I will not fear what man shall do unto me. Man can't do nothing to you that God won't allow to. So if God, no, let me put that, God loves you, and if that situation arises, God has already told you in his word, he's always there for you. He's there because he knows you. He knows you better than anyone. He knew Peter better than anyone. And he's telling you today, I know you, Elder Stubblefield. I know you, Pastor. I know you, Sister Elizabeth. I know you, Sister. How y'all body see? He knows the sisters. He knows the brothers. Amen. God knows us. And he is, verse 8 says, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. That means he ain't changing. You may change, but he ain't gonna change. He's still Jesus. He's still Lord, and he still loves you. Yeah, we get beside ourselves sometime and we get to saying things and get to doing things, but God is always there and he's always, always on time. And in this moment and in this time, I thank God for he's always there. He's always there. Greater light, no, God is always there. He is there. God can't fail. Man fails, but God never fails. You know why? He's God. He knows your name. He knows exactly who you are. He's a good God. You hear pastor saying he's a good God? He's a good God. He's good, he's good, he's good. Greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world or of the world. And see, I know this because guess what? The greatness of God exceeds and excels where man fails. You heard somebody tell you you never make it, or you can't do it, or anything. But my Lord and Savior tells me I can do all things through him who strengthens me. It means you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. He knows you. He knows you. He knows you. Oh, praise the Lord. And he's in it with you. That's sweet. Turn with me to Psalms 100. Amen. Psalm 100. Oh, praise the Lord. And the word is enter.
for that. Psalm 100 says this: make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye land. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before the presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that has made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people and his sheep of his pasture. Enter into the gates with thanksgiving, and unto his courts with praise. Be thankful unto the Lord and bless his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his truth endured to all generations. Oh, amen, amen, amen. Verse 1 says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye land. That means greater light, be excited. Let the devil know you're making a noise unto your Lord, because he's been good to you. He's been good to you. He's been good to you. Verse 2 says, serve the Lord with gladness. Come before the presence with singing. Serve him with gladness. Are you ready to serve the Lord with the gladness that he has given you? And sing unto the Lord. You know, I think about God's been so good that at times when God's been so good, you sing with gladness. And I mean, I believe every one of us have sung unto the Lord because of the gladness that he's given unto us. You know, us that can sing and us that cannot sing. But we sang unto the Lord because of gladness, because of his goodness. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. And the verse says, know ye that the Lord, he is God. You know he's God. I know he's God. It is he that has made us, and not we ourselves. It is he that's given life unto us, and not we ourselves. Not me, not us. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. We are his children. God ain't forgot about us. He ain't not forgot about any of us. Why? Because he knows our name. He knows your name. So in that midnight storm and in that moment, he knows you. And now you have to face the fact that God knows me. Do I know him? Like I say, I know him. Do I love him? Like I say, I love him. Do you love him? Do you know him? Amen. His name is Jesus. Jesus Almighty. I like to play a song unto your hearing, but that is all this morning that God has given to me for his people, because he knows you and he knows me. He knows our name. So I'll play the song unto your hearing and I'll be done. Amen. God bless you. Just listen and let it minister to you and what it means to you. I know what it means to me. So greater light, God knows your name. And the two things that stuck out to me in that song is we're kingdom people and the devil is under our feet. God bless you. I pray your strength in the name of Jesus. That's all I have for you. Amen.